Larry, we just watched the run through, but first let's get the title. I still don't think I know what it is.
Mad Rush.
It is still Mad Rush.
Yeah, it's still.
Okay.
Which is coincidentally the title of the music.
Coincidentally, yes.
I was really adventurous.
Very creative of you. Very, very inspired of
yes.
you. So I would just want to rewind a couple of weeks and then we'll end up back where we are right now. On October 10th, which was two rehearsals ago, you actually, at the time, made a rare statement, I thought. You said what the piece was about.
Oh, I did?
Yes. You said, this piece is about a spiraling of emotion.
Mm.
So 2 weeks later, mm-hmm. how does that seem to you?
I love it. I think that's exactly what I think it is, a spiraling of emotion, and with hints of loneliness and... sort of a spiral of any emotion,
mm-hmm. yeah. as emotions tend to do.
Yeah, and they like as emotions, someone used the word watching it the other day of cascading. So sort yeah. of how emotions wash over you.
And when you have the, is it called a shell or when you have them go?
Oh, I say scallop.
Oh, scallop. I
mean, yeah, just like the shape of a scallop. And so they're scalloping around. Which is part of that cascading, like a constant water flow, a waterfall of emotion coming on and off the stage, individually and as a group.
So having just seen a run through a few minutes ago, how do you feel at this point in terms of, just in terms of where it is in its life, shall we say?
I'm very happy. I'm content, but I still want to work on it.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm a little bit chomping at the bit, a little bit frustrated because I want more time.
So tell me what's like the number one thought that's pressing in your mind right now about it, if there's something specific. Because remember you said 2 weeks ago, you said you felt like, oh, you had at least 3/4 of it was already done. And you're
yeah.
just going to recycle one part of it. And now I feel like it has become much more elaborate.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, thanks. I feel like the structure is
mm-hmm.
there,
mm-hmm.
but I want to get more into the quality and into the sort of the essence of it for the dancers. And I want to give them the opportunity to own it more.
Mm-hmm.
And so for me to let go of that, I have to feel secure in that I've gotten all my notes out.
Yes, your notes.
Yeah.
Your notes. Speaking of your notes, the other thing you said was, this was just last week,
mm-hmm.
only a week ago, you must have used the word, you must have said you were going to change this thing about, I have at least 5 or 6 times, I'm going to change it, I may change it,
yeah.
It's all about change. When you say that you want to change it though, I think you don't mean revise, it seems like you mean expand or edit or something. I don't think
no
you
I mean
well what
I,
do
no
you
I do think that I'm making
oh.
drafts. I still am drafting. I'm making revisions and
mm-hmm.
you know, you're not going to enter downstage, you're going to enter upstage. So there are small changes, but there's a lot of small changes that amount to some big changes.
Mm-hmm. But you don't think there's an ecology in a dance like this that's so complicated that when you change one thing it axiomatically has some effect on something else.
It does. No, that does exist. And sometimes I'm unaware of that and I let the dancers figure it out, make
mm-hmm.
the, you know, solve the problems. But, and I'm grateful that they do. But I still can't let that stop me from making changes.
No, I understand.
You know, I have to just push through that and say, you know, I don't have time to find the solution. I just know that this needs to change. Can you help me find the solution?
And then you see another change and that makes you realize something else.
Yes. And so in a way, you almost have to be this late in the game making changes. You almost have to be extra diligent in practicing the law of detachment and the law of least resistance and all of those, you know, spiritual laws so that you have the courage to make the change and that you have the courage to trust your instincts.
Well, one of the most incredible things I noticed today was some of the changes you made. You would say to somebody, can you just do that? The next time we do it, can you just do that
in
a different way? And then they go, they it sticks in their mind.
Yeah.
But you realize you're working with people that can handle that kind of thing, yeah. Obviously.
Definitely.
Yeah, they definitely can. So another thing you mentioned in the last few weeks was the world of the dance. I meant mm-hmm. to ask you about that last time. When you say the world of the dance, what is the image in your mind? Is it just this room, or what do you
of
mean by the
dance?
World of the dance? Yeah.
Oh, I feel like for a dance to have cohesion, you are creating a world,
and
creating a world, and so sometimes when making choices, I ask myself, does that fit in this world? Because it might not be this dance. That choice that I'm making might be for another dance, right? And so to sort of help fine-tune the editing process, I ask myself, does that belong in this world? Or, but it could be as simple as right now you need to be walking off the stage, not running, because that's how I'm relating to the music. And that's the end of my answer. I was going on a tangent.
In my mind, this works, but in the bodies, it doesn't. Now, that really got me today.
Oh, today.
That was a good one.
Yeah, sometimes. Yeah, sometimes when I'm looking at the video, I see something, and my imagination makes it correct. Mm. But I'm not accounting for all the variation of dancers and what they're doing, and so. I hate when that happens, and that happens pretty often. I'll be falling asleep thinking of something, like, oh, that's what I'm gonna do. And then as soon as I get the body in front of me, it doesn't work.
That's fascinating,
yeah.
Really interesting. When in doubt, be you, don't be a dancer.
Yeah, I feel like there's...
Is that something, I don't want to put you on the spot, but do you say that besides here at Montclair State?
Oh my God, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
I'm very much about,
I
want to see the person on the stage just be going through the tasks or whatever the drill is. I don't want to see the dancer. Of course, they're all incredible, beautiful dancers with wonderful facility and technique, and I like to see that. Mm-hmm. But when it comes to the transitional moments or the emotive moments or the walking, running, sort of the pedestrian moments, I want to see pedestrian. I don't want to see pedestrian adapted to dance.
Now, just to go off of this genre, when I was preparing today, I thought about a quote from John Ruskin, who, as you may know, was a 19th century English art critic. And he wrote an essay on the subject of how a painter knows when his painting is finished. Mm-hmm. And I feel like that's very much more applicable to a painting when you have one more stroke and you back away from it. You say, but this construct of biography of a dance now seems to me to be somewhat artificial because it's not over.
No.
And it, see what I mean?
Yeah, I don't mean to be so esoteric, but it quite possibly is never over.
No, that's not esoteric. I feel that.
Because,
I feel it.
We created this dance here, but if I want, I can restage this dance with a whole nother crew of dancers, and it would be totally different. And so there was this incredible show recently at the museum, what are they calling it? The Met Breuer?
Yeah, the former of 75th Street.
Yeah, it was called Unfinished. And it's like all these amazing masterpieces.
The whole show was
Whole show is unfinished works. Some of which were unfinished. Some of which were somewhat finished works on top of three other works. Like painted on top of. So I love that idea. And I don't think in the dance community we give ourselves the permission to retouch a work.
You see, this is what I feel now that I've been doing this for a while. I see that I now realize that you can't ever talk about something that's physical as being finished. Mm-mm. I mean, you're coming back next week. Mm-hmm. Then we have Diane Sichel, who's going to be working with everybody for quite a while after that. Mm-hmm. Then we have the show. Mm-hmm. And then you have notes from the show. Mm-hmm. So do you think that maybe that's just part of the art form? It's just, is there such a thing as something actually being finished?
No, because also, casting changes, energy, you could be sick one night and not give it all, so there's so many variables that make the art form such a livable, breathing experience, which is why we go to the theater, because there's that anticipation of what might happen and what might not happen.
Now, the last thing I want to just ask you tonight is, I was very hung up for a long time on what a dance was about when I was watching it. And I feel like in the last few weeks, I realized I haven't thought about it at all. In terms of it being about a specific narrative thing, as opposed to having more of an ambiance or something.
I think if there's one thing for me that this is about, is community. And so I guess more the abstract is it's this flow of emotion, but as people, they're a community.
They definitely are. And I think one of the things you've done so beautifully is create a sense of community among all of them, but then you also see each individual as who they are. So thank you so much.
Oh, thank you. Such a pleasure. And thank you.
Thank you.